Madden 19. I'm the coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. Up next, we've got a good one on tap between the visiting Arizona Cardinals and the San Francisco 49ers. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half. But it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a short time ago, this crowd had loved their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with the Arizona Cardinals. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Godden alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at these 49ers as they interplay here. And losers their last time out, so they'll look to make amends here.
And one of the best ways you can do that is to be at home, and they are. They're going to try and ride that home crowd and that wave of emotion to a victory in this one.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Cardinals here, they're hitting their stride of late, winners of three of their last four.
And if you look back to last week, it was all about their defense. Anytime you hold an NFL team to single digits, that's saying something.
Here's Robinson. Not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. And here's a look at their leader, standing 6'4".
And I liked what his head coach told us about him this week, that no matter what happens, whether he throws seven interceptions or seven touchdown passes, he's the same assertive leader in the huddle on each and every play. He can throw the seven interceptions, just blame the football, blame anything else, and still carry himself like he is the man.
It's like you, assertive in our production meetings.
Well, especially when we're talking about ordering dinner.
Intercepted. Picked up by the veteran Antoine Bethea. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. And they told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. Bradford gonna lead the Cardinals up now, first and 10 at their own 44. Johnson, who almost missed all of last year. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. So we'll look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stacked your team just the way you're supposed to.
And he gets it down deep into San Francisco territory. Here we go.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock the defense off balance, that'll drive the team towards a victory.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these players make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is a well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going to play action since you ran it twice. But I don't think the second down is the time you go play action throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
Only a yard there, so it brings up fourth and goal.
Now, this feels like old school football because this has turned into a good old-fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on fourth down?
So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But the NFL, defense is awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just ball.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know, they're the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team. They tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. Let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for them, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense. Any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame, get used to the ground shaking, so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
And they'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets them a new set of downs.
I know what you're thinking out there. A little lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield, it's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. Right now, I think they're just trying to get some momentum going. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
Given 7 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top-5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high-powered, you got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're over 28-30, that could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace. This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the Pro Bowl, but oh so effective. Nice completion there, keeps the sticks moving.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41. And a quick look now at the offense for the 49ers.
And DeSean Jackson is the guy that your eyes naturally gravitate towards because he's a big play waiting to happen. In his career, usually averages about 20 yards a catch. Last season in 2017, closer to 13 yards per catch. Look for him to be recommitted to getting back downfield and catching the long ball.
Looking to throw. Johnson, wide open receiver, complete. For the extra point. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Gold now out to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. A chance for us to look now at this 49ers defense. And we're going to get a peek at some of the hits that have helped them get this first half lead.
And you know how the best hits happen? By being really good on that side of the ball in terms of fundamentals. Being in the right spot, diagnosing plays well, and being there at the point of attack. They are really making it happen.
Bradford going to lead the Cardinals up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. First and 10, Bradford. And that's caught left side. Seals Jones with it. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be 2nd and 9.
Can you do any more work or make it more dramatic for not much gain than what we just saw there. Did you see how his toes got down? Tip-tap, tip-tap, got him down. What did he get out of it?
He sold the sizzle. He just had no stop.
Maybe it was a 1 yard.
Well, you pose like that, you at least expect a first down there, just 1 yard. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sign of relief, no doubt. That's a good fight on this lead to the ground. And now the third down throw incomplete as well. That makes him now 0 for 2 here in the first quarter on third down conversions.
And now they'll look to their defense because they need them to step up so they don't fall further behind here in the early going.
With it is Jackson. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And that last drive, a long drive. But not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no good plays by the defense to knock the ball away. Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy set the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
McKinnon fitting in nicely as the feature back in his 49er offense. He's back there again now on first down. Right back to him on first down. And he'll get it across midfield and down to the Cardinal territory. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he goes down the ball before getting this inside the 25. That one goes for 24 yards.
The goal of any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver where any defender can step up and catch it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Time for us to introduce you to the defensive starters for Arizona. And this unit, very tough to throw against. Currently second best in the NFL.
And it's really difficult to prepare for this team. This is the number one overall passing team in the NFL. But it shouldn't be hard to get excited about playing against them. The ultimate test going against that unit.
And that's why you and I are excited to broadcast this game.
Yes, sir.
Let's go!
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Johnson escaping the pressure right. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a 3rd down.
Throw.
Johnson. And they're going to get to him. A sack. the 9-yard line. Not after the sack, he's still down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. Garoppolo. This will be caught at about the 5. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal. Garoppolo now on 3rd and goal. And it's complete. Touchdown 49ers. His guys are in for 6. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. Still first quarter, 2 receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch a better cover guy to it. Or you make sure you have more people in his general area wherever he lines up to at least try and discourage them from throwing the ball to him.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. So you got to go out and create some offense plays here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
It wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
The numbers for Johnson in last week's game. 18 carries, 78 yards, and a touchdown.
He's having a nice season. And he knows where he ranks him. They don't know about running back, tell you that they don't know that. They do. So what he's doing now, robbing the offensive coordinator all week long. Hey, how about a few more touches? He's one big game away from maybe leading the league.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Give him 8 yards on the play, and they pick up the first.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sends it. The screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. They worked very well there for a first down.
One quarter in the books. Plenty of scoring here already. We're back to Santa Clara after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaughton, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals. On second down, Johnson. Looks like right at the 40. Call it a gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring a 3rd and 8.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits. And these creases like they were able to explore right there.
Bradford. And this one off for Fitzgerald. So they took a shot there on 3rd down. Couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on 3rd down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. 3rd down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here 1st and 10 at the 20. They go play action here on 1st down. To the right side, caught by Salah. And they'll get him down here at the 23. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down.
And partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Garoppolo going to try and throw on third. He's going to walk one deep left side here. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball is intercepted, but it is third down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right?
You're trying to... And it's intercepted by the end zone! Ruben Foster picks it.
Los Angeles Super Bowl where Joe Theismann tried to throw the screen pass. I can't remember the number, but he tried to throw the screen pass and Jeff Sparrow got it with no one around and just waltzed in and pretty much broke their backs. That's a similar play, although this one didn't have to run at all.
Ah, here we go. Stats guy Johnny on the spot. Super Bowl 18, 38 to 9. It was in Tampa. So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. And he's got it. So the try for two, successful. Bumps their lead up even further. And there's a quick momentum swing. INT return for pick six, and then the two-point conversion good.
And even if you're keeping your wits about you, you're thinking to yourself, okay, extra point block team going into the game now. All of a sudden you're hearing defense, everyone's scrambling for their helmets and throwing down their cups of water. That's a great position for them to be in, trying to score against that team. A little bit disjointed.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This is T.J. Logan to return it. And a loose step there. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him.
Here we go. 120!
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And bringing it in, it's a shot. And they work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 12 yards here as they move the chains.
It is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it too deep? Is it three deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots in the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback. He should be reading the exact same thing, and they cut the ball right on you.
And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Holding offense.
You need your wide receivers as
still first down.
Sometimes they get a hold.
the big runs are often a result of what they do on the perimeter. In this case, got caught holding, and this one will come back.
Point and a route is on here in this first half. Gold now out to kick it away. With it on the return is Logan. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. Bradford going to lead the Cardinals up now, first and 10 at their own 26.
Hey, fourth and hot. And 80. And hot, and hot.
They begin the drive with Johnson. He finds an opening past the 40. The 40. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, Cardinals. David Johnson. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Cardinals cut into that lead. They blitzed defensively there, but he was able to slip through that first layer, and then he was gone.
I think they won the leverage game, didn't they?
Yes.
Right? They saw the blitz coming. That got to him a little bit, but they leveraged it perfectly and found not just a crease, a gigantic hole. And off he goes, and he's still going all the way to the end zone.
Here's Phil Dawson now for the point after. Dawson tacks on the point after, and the lead is down to 28-10. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. San Francisco gets set to go here. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. A little too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
To throw, it's Garoppolo. And it's Kittle. And up to the 45 before the radio knocked him down. Garoppolo was tight end Kittle for a Niner first down.
That's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. If we talk about finding the soft spot defensively, how do you make sure they don't find a soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards it.
They run it with McKinnon. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency.
Throwing out first is Garoppolo. He's going to let this one go deep. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Back to the air on second. It's Garoppolo. And he took that in one-handed. What a grab. Two touchdowns for him already in this first half. This one good for a first down. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And he's got this down close to the 20 before he's dropped. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
McKinnon, he's to the 10. And down to the 7-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Lots of plays on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
This will be called about the 5.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. And this one's incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Looking to throw. Garoppolo. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And this is why golfers do their best, to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Bradford going to lead the Cardinals up now, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Following the interception, Bradford. That's caught on the left side by Kirk. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Here's a second and 5 now from the 25. Now a 10th carry for Johnson. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here. 3rd and a yard. The Cardinals on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. All right, coming up at intermission. Charles, you want to wait in hence your Saturday?
I certainly do.
I've got just a thing for you. It's the coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by Orlando. He'll be alongside at half to take us through the weekend in the NFL. The Cardinals on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. From the shotgun, it's Bradford. They couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Well, first down throw for Bradford. He's going to take a shot to the end zone. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
I think it's high time to get him some passes that he's comfortable with, some easy throws, some completions. He's not even hitting the 50% thus far.
Well, certainly that has played a big role into why they are trailing right now.
Throwing again, Bradford on second and 10. This one complete to Jermaine Gresham. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
But he made that catch knowing full well that at the end of it, he's going to catch a pretty good lick.
I guess if there's anyone on this team that can absorb a pop, it's him.
Bradford on third and 2. And he's got Gresham. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. They're able to convert on third down. And that sets up a first and goal. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in a shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more.
He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. J.J. Nelson, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Cardinals get a bit closer.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps. But they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in the second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. Dawson able to connect on the extra point, and the lead is down to 11 at 28-17. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Defensively, they snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're just going to defeat him back and make sure no one picks it up. Or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try to make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. The Niners on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5.
Here we go. 180!
Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. All back for a hit, and this will be caught. Now the timeout signaled for. They'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Garoppolo in the offense with a 1st and 10, and he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Garoppolo again. He's going to go down. They get to the back of the 40. And offensively, they'll take the touchdown with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 16.
Move it up, fellas.
Garoppolo looks to throw. His pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off at the 16. Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you, too, in just a bit. But first, let's get everybody caught up with what's going on around the NFL here in Week 5. We'll kick it off with a good one in the NFC West. L.A. heading north to take on Seattle. And it's the Rams who have the lead in the second quarter. Robert Woods, a touchdown reception. From there, we head east to check on the Bills at home in Buffalo. And they were losers in that one as they fall to the visiting Tennessee Titans. Marcus Mariota, 4 touchdown passes in the victory. Finally, let's get over to Carson, see what's happening with the Chargers at home at the StubHub Center.
And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently, we're going to get right back to it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. With it on the return is Logan. Gets past one man. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. On the NFL scoreboard, they are in the second up in Seattle. It's the Rams that have grabbed the early lead. Jared Goff with 2 first-half touchdown passes. And they start the second half with Johnson. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. And oh, Johnson dinged up a bit. Still down. Hopefully nothing serious. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that. But it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. But most of his bread and butter is a good running back down the play.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring out the third down.
And that's called winning at the point of attack, isn't it? Right there at the line of scrimmage. I know he's a little bummed out now. He doesn't get credit for a tackle for a loss, but no gain. His guys will take that.
Speaking of winning, to be as cheesy as we can, he is the winner of the NFC Defensive Player of the Week award from last week, so he's really streaming together some good football.
So not only did he get a gold star, he might have gotten a gold watch, too, huh? But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Yeah, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion.
Illegal touching, offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Throw now. It is on end zone. Now the Mariners complete. And he's able to get this one right pretty close to 30. And it goes for a gain of 31.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gain. That's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. If you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, you start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup, and on that play, it went for good yardage.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Here again is McKinnon, and the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. The tackle made there by Dayon Buchanan.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Jamar Taylor. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Bradford now to throw on first down. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. It's a gain of 19 down to the 19, and it's a first down. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came out throwing the football after the catch on that balance.
And he did. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Nelson. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. So it looks like somebody may have forgotten the snap count, and a five-yard penalty ensues.
False start, offense.
So that'll back them up five. They were looking good on second down, but now they're backed up 5 yards by the false start, and it's second and eight.
Hey, we got the hunt. Ready?
This is Logan. And the agility got him a few extra before he's taken down right at the 10. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. And they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's first and goal.
That was a tremendous group effort there, because when you talk about offensive lines, the best ones, talk about guys that play in harmony, in sync, and getting things done, and they did that in that play.
Yeah, especially on third and one, got to be in sync, and they were. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to clear up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
And a hit dragged loose. It's incomplete.
When you got your backs in the shadow of your goal line, you've got to be physical in that situation, because there's not a whole lot of space, not a lot of wild plays that can be run there.
It's put up or shut up time. Defensively, nice job just to make sure they didn't complete it on that play. Throwing, Bradford. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by a Kevin Witherspoon. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Oh, he's got him in wide open for Green. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Right way to start the drive. 20 big ones in a first down.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle. You put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Middle of the field, it's Robinson. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. The reception good for 7. It's third down. A second down completion got him 7. Now here's 3rd and 3. And yet again, it's Garoppolo. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. 8th catch for him now. He's been a big factor. And it's a first down.
Well, from an offense's perspective, that sure was pretty. Because the corner route, it's extremely difficult to defend from my perspective.
What we just saw there, is that sort of the evolution of the tight end position?
Yeah, I think it is, because more and more, tight ends are being treated like wide receivers.
And it's good play. In the end zone, touchdown 49ers. In for the score. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead.
Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what. With his first 5 minutes, first 3, whatever. This was a big score to start the second half.
Gold able to tack on the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Gold now out to kick it away. With it on the return is Logan. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else will flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Second down, Bradford. Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Bradford finding Nelson for an Arizona first down. Bradford now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10. They run with Logan. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward to get what he can.
They run again with Logan. Tackle that time by Jarquiski Tart.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Bradford from the gun on 3rd down. And he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
And that is going to do it. for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's Cardinal football, but they trail here as we get set to bring you the fourth and final quarter. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Bradford on first down. The middle of the field, he's got Nelson. And he's got this down to the 35. 14 yards at time for number 14.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them. And they run that quick cut on the slant. And oftentimes they're
taking it right down Broadway. Touchdown, Cardinals. Jermaine Gresham, his second touchdown on the season. And the Cardinals cut into that lead.
Remember the one-dimensional tight ends who just put their hand in the ground and block people? Well, if you're that guy now, you're probably a fullback in an I formation offense. These tight ends nowadays can do everything. Block, run, and catch. Beautiful connection for a touchdown.
Dawson tacks on the point after, and that will get him one closer. Jackson now to return. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
Well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. What a good pickup of 28 yards. So there on that play, offensively, they're in the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage, so as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. No moving across the net. If you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And they move this all the way down to the 9. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do that to use.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Corey Peters. He's the one that finally runs him down, and that is a big, big loss. 18 yards.
I think you saw the same thing that I did there, partner. Remember, he's their backup quarterback, so the last thing they need is to lose another one right here on the set. Looks like he's going to be okay.
Yeah, he looked like he was favoring something in the left leg. Appears to be fine now, but you're right. That O-line, they got to protect it. Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
This
thing off, but it's still ate up time, got points. So, while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Now it's Gold after splitting the uprights to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's
to hold.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, trying to get them out.
Now out to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Sam Bradford heading back out as he and his offense get ready to go again. And that interception that ended their previous drive likely also ended any shot they had at victory.
Yeah, long road back from here, no doubt about that. But let's face it, you're going to go out there and compete.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up near the 44. And a pound of all in the red zone at the 16-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. Now these guys hardly got a chance to catch their breath after the quick turnover, but I doubt they're complaining much.
Especially with the field position they get to start with. I wouldn't be complaining either. I want to get right back out there and get after them because now you have an opportunity to make a big play. I'd say let's be aggressive and go after
it. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
Well, partner, Marvin, our number one stats guy, just handed me a little card that says he has 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to get the ball again?
I think so. Three away from that century mark, gotta have it.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to find is one of his favorite runs, whatever he feels comfortable with, and with the offensive line has executed well today, to try and get him over 100 yards.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one, despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did it
across the track. Into the end zone, it's a 49-yard touchdown. George Kittle, his third touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Niners take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. Now Gold for the extra point. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and that'll increase their lead to 28. Now it's Gold after splitting the uprights to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Bradford going to lead the Cardinals up now. First and 10 at their 25-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And they'll bring it down at the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out.
Incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Now on third down, that pass knocked down in the backfield and incomplete.
Anytime the ball's thrown in the middle of the field, it's popped up in the air. I expect someone to catch. Doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Almost outkicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on a return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now it's the fullback. This is Kyle Juszczyk. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
That's someone who's pretty happy right there. That's the defense coordinator. Body after body getting to him before he can get started.
First man through. It's the fullback, Juszczyk. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. Tackle made there by Josh Bynes.
And that was a good collision right there. And I know this as a former defender. If you're playing linebacker, you're going through a checklist on every play of who you think's going to get the ball, where you think the ball's going to go. Rarely do you expect the fullback position to get it. And on that play, you did. So you've got to steel yourself at that point because the contact is going to be strong.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several. And look at this. It's a fake. And now he bows him over. And he won't get there. They stop it a few yards short of the line to gain. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool them. It's such a risky play there to fake it. You're either the hero or the goat. Here they're going to be the goat.
Unfortunate, too, because you know they thought they had something there. They don't call it just to call. They don't just say, oh, what the heck, let's go and fake it here. They feel like they've got something now, and they got the defense in the right spot. Just unsuccessful in that opportunity.
Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. On second down, Bradford again. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the shotgun, it's Bradford.
Execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at the 20. Now McKinnon to start the drive. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads. Bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to run that now. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there. It's good enough to move the chains.
always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? Not like any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away.
Here we go.
Here's McKinnon. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
Yeah, let me puff out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. That was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game. Extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They'll go for it. It's Garoppolo. He's going to walk down deep left side here.
Just like that. You know, some philosophies, some coaches are like, well, but I got a chance to put some more points on the board. I don't care what the situation. The same coaches, as a general rule, that if someone does it to them, you won't hear people protest out of them. That's just who they are.
Single, single. Here we go. Hunt. Red 80. Red 80.
On first and 10, Bradford. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Second and 10 now from the 27. Second and 10. That is caught at the 7. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Jermaine Gresham with now 2 fourth quarter touchdowns. And the Cardinals get a bit closer.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Dawson able to connect on the extra point, and that will shave one more off this lead. Jackson now to return. San Francisco gets set to go here. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. Right? And sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Hassan Reddick in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Too great, and he goes down once more. And want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. So the sack of Garoppolo, and now what can they come up with on third and long? Garoppolo, he's going to walk one deep left side here. And now here's another interception. Picked off at the 19. Well, they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. Six interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out. One last shot now for Bradford. That will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for San Francisco, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Green Bay Packers. Meanwhile, for the Cardinals, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And they'll be off to Minneapolis next week for a look at new U.S. Bank Stadium and a date with the Vikings. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The 49ers.